annual conference is, as Dr. Suleri would know, is something which is very close to my heart, simply because I see it as a means for solving a very large number of our core problems in Pakistan. There are different aspects of it, but the aspect which makes me most excited and the opportunity that I think has the greatest potential impact is what I call the democratization of business in Pakistan. Business in Pakistan is controlled by, or controlled maybe too strong a word, but definitely influenced by large business houses with large pools of capital. They are the ones who have access to policy formulation. They are the ones, obviously, they have the capital, and they have access to even more capital in the shape of the banking industry and even the capital markets. And therefore, I've always maintained that in the Pakistani economy, those who have the greatest, or those who have the best ideas, who are willing to work hard, who are willing to take entrepreneurial risks, are not necessarily the ones who become the biggest winners. It is those who have got the most influence and have the ability to influence policy and decisions. And what the digital platform does is it allows you to break through that the barrier. And from very small, it's examples of girls sitting at home in rural areas and being able to conduct business and earn a livelihood for themselves, to potentially the startups becoming multi-billion rupees companies and hopefully at some point in time, multi-billion dollar companies. So there's this whole spectrum which is available. Revenue generation, documentation of the economy is such a massive challenge for Pakistan. I've strongly believed, and we took more than one steps in that direction. I won't go into the details of that. I've talked about them earlier. Of using technology to achieve this end rather than the muscle and might of the FPR officer. I'm convinced even today that the ultimate solution, the ultimate breakthroughs will come through digitization of the economy much more so than they will come from the gallant efforts of the FPR officers. I'm sure they're trying very, very hard. We're looking at efficient delivery of services to the citizens, and technology obviously has a remarkable role to play there. I was driving very recently, and I drove past this place in I-9, and there was a lot of cars there. It's a real traffic jam. And what were they all doing? They were all there to pay the motor vehicle tax. I mean, in this day and age of technology, you shouldn't have to leave home to be able to pay this. You talk about accountability and transparency of governance and making the government accountable to its citizens. And again, I've said this many times, if you are able to digitize what is being done by the government, put it on open platforms, the youth of Pakistan will be able to hold the government of Pakistan accountable in more meaningful ways and more powerfully than the NAB is able to do. So there are so many different aspects in which the promotion of the digital economy is extremely of extreme importance for Pakistan. But at the same time, I also recognize what was being said by Mr. Kaka Khail, that is also a fact that there is and has emerged a digital divide. So this digitization or this development of the digital economy should not only be designed for those who can find their way into Margala Hotel at the invitation of SDPI and are able to understand the English language, but this would only be a success if all 200 million plus citizens of Pakistan were able to benefit from this. Pakistan took some good decisions in this regard. I mean, there's more than one, but there is one that particularly I want to highlight, and that was the creation of the Universal Service Fund. very, very good idea. And the whole idea was that the revenue which is generated from the more affluent and citizens in the more developed parts of the country, a part of that should be used to provide access to remote areas where people are not so affluent and where it does not necessarily initially at least make commercial sense for you to be spreading your digital networks. The Universal Service Fund has gone through ups and downs. There have been periods in which it has done great work. There have been periods where it has been neglected. There was also an instance where tens of billions of rupees of the Universal Service Funds were taken away to finance the fiscal deficit. Dr. Suleri should know about that. Since we are a non-political platform, we shall not name who did it. So that's just one example of good, sensible thinking, which led to creation of a very, very powerful institution which can do a lot to bridge the, and has done a lot to bridge the digital divide, but obviously there is a lot more that needs to be done. Of course, if you want to truly bridge the digital divide, it will go beyond the information technology ministry or those dealing directly with technology. If people don't even have basic literacy, then it is unlikely that they will be able to make full advantage or full use of the digital technology. So it's a whole of the government approach which needs to be taken in order to be able to do that. On the recommendation of Dr. Suleri, and I take this liberty because he's a friend and we worked together for quite a number of years now. So Dr. Suleri, whenever I talk to people, I'm sure if I talk to anybody in this room and take them aside and say, what do you think about the government of Pakistan and how it works? And they'll say, it is terrible, it doesn't work, and you know, the government is useless, we should not use the government. At the same time, I never attend a function, a seminar, or a conference where people don't recommend government of Pakistan to do even more things. So I take your advice with some caution. And the other thing that I've noticed in this regard, what you've just said is, maybe because there's great allure to technology, I see everybody in the government coming in from different angles trying to do exactly what you're doing. So I'm personally a very strong believer in empowering the Information Technology Ministry. And whoever else has great ideas should work from that, because there has to be a common platform. You can't just have kamikaze pilots going off on their own just because they think they can do more good than the others. However, having said all of this, your basic point that there needs to be a coordinated effort where not just the federal and the provincial ministries, provincial governments collaborate, the different ministries within the federal government collaborate, the private sector collaborates, the academia collaborates. I completely endorse that idea, and that is certainly something that attempts have been made to make that happen, perhaps not with complete success, and therefore we need to revisit that and see if we can make that even more successful. Thank you very much, not just for inviting me, for all the great work that the SDPI has been doing, and hope that the rest of the deliberations end up with recommendations which would be of use, and may Allah grant the decision makers the sagacity and the willingness and the time to be able to benefit from those recommendations and make something out of those. Thank you very much.